other talk side. On intravitreal injection. At the outset, I thank AIOS for giving me the opportunity. This is a new technique of intravitreal injection. We usually, the intravitreal injections are widely used to administer anti-VEGF, triamcinolone, antibiotics, TPA, etc. Distinct advantage is an immediate therapeutic effect at the intended site. The problem and risk of intravitreal injection technique, that is vitreous incarceration in the needle tract, vitreous weak through the scleral tunnel, vitreous and drug reflex under the conjunctiva, that is a bleb formation, and immediate rise in IOP. Transient CRA occlusion, that is a sudden central blackout, the risk of endophthalmitis and RD. To avoid vitreous reflux, many surgeons are opted for making tunneled or biplanar injection. Thinner needles are used and cotton tip applicator is applied for few seconds. So post injection, you can get intraocular volume is raised, vitreous reflux is raised, is there, optic disc perfusion is reduced, and CRA occlusion can occur. So I will show you the video. So what I did in this technique, my new technique is the 26 or 30 gauge needle is used, and it is mounted on a sterile Johnson bud. Just for demonstration, I am using unsterile technique, but it is mounted on the Johnson bud. And now this is used as a pre-injection paracentesis. Before giving intravitreal injection, this is used as a pre-injection paracentesis. So 26 or 30 gauge needle, any needle can be used. Now before giving injection, just mark the injection site. So now this is the pre-injection paracentesis. I am going through the stromal lamellae and just entering inside the anterior chamber, not going deep inside, only the needle is just inside the anterior chamber. And now intravitreal injection is given. While giving the injection, the aqueous is egressed out through this pre-injection paracentesis so that there will not be any bleb formation or the vitreous incarceration, and IOP rise will not be there. Now this is the second case I am showing. This is the pre-injection paracentesis device. Just very simple device, inexpensive device. Can we go little less forward, fast forward? Aseptic precautions were used. Eye wash is given, thorough eye wash. Now this is the pre-injection paracentesis device. Initially I was skeptical, but nowadays I modified this technique and I am just poking inside or going inside the corneal stroma, and then tangentially, and then the needle tip is just inside the anterior chamber so that it will not harm the iris or the lens or other intraocular structures. After marking the needle site, injection site, the advantage is you won't get any IOP rise or any bleb formation or any other complication related to intravitreal injection. It is very helpful in endophthalmitis cases where we have to inject many antibiotics. So in that case, chances of IOP rise, and again you have to go do the paracentesis, and again you have to inject the antibiotic. But in this device, if we use this device, you don't have to do paracentesis again and again. So it is a pre-injection paracentesis. Why the Johnson bud is used, bare needle is not used? Because if you use needle directly, it will reduce the pressure. And hypotony, in hypotonous eye, it is difficult to give intravitreal injection. So it will act as a guard for inner opening. So advantage I already told you.
Yes, sir.
So in one study, we found that the bleb formation is only 0.8%, fundus CRA pulsation is 1.61%, vitreous incarceration 0.4%, RD was not there, pain was drastically reduced. When I asked the patient about the pain, there was no pain. So dramatic effect of this new technique on intraoperative posture.
Can you summarize,
sir? Okay.
So I compared with other studies and we found it was very efficacious and very helpful. To conclude, this is a simple, inexpensive technique and is found very safe for all types of intravitreal injections. Thank you very much.